Inspiring children to read can come from parents, friends, and now in St. Paul, even a vending machine. Kaya Edwards explains how it's opening up a new world of opportunities.
Leave him alone, snap test.
Mom Kim McAdory says her four-year-old, Jalia, loves books.
He's trying to swim down there.
I think he's trying to sleep.
Even if she can't quite read.
She's not really reading yet, but she'll point at the words. We have a lot of books at home.
Now Jalia has access to even more books, not off the shelves, but in a vending machine at Benjamin Mays Elementary, her school. The school's partner, St. Paul Promise Neighborhood, brought in the machine.
Answer.
Unveiling it alongside Mayor Melvin Carter, who went to kindergarten here.
When I was your age, we would open the books, and not a lot of the books had people in them that looked like me.
All of the books are written by local Black authors.
I love my students being able to see themselves reflected in books. The more opportunities that we can get books in students' hands, the more excited they are about it.
Instead of paying money, students will earn tokens to use in the machine.
Getting it out of a vending machine has this whole air of excitement to it.
This is the second book vending machine in the district. The other is at Maxfield Elementary School.
Those involved say the machines align with other commitments to improve literacy rates in St. Paul Public Schools. This school year, the district launched SPPS Reads, an initiative incorporating evidence-based science of reading practices.
It might be something different we don't have. So it's always a good thing, yeah, to get something different and new.
Kaya Edwards, Care 11 News.